Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Cube. Adam and I have been running to a lot of people that really want to kick the tires on the Lakehouse, but they're like, we don't write Python, we don't know how to get started. We just want to do some testing, upload some files and get started, pin more data to the tables that we create. How do we do it? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you. And I'm going to show you, and we're going to write very little to no code. So let's call it low code. So instead of all this talking, you know, I like to do, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So let's say you've created a workspace that's backed by premium capacity or fabric or something like that. And then in the workspace, you choose new Lakehouse and you create your first Lakehouse. It's going to create a SQL endpoint, a default data set, and of course your Lakehouse. So we go to your Lakehouse and then you'll get the tables and the folders section and you create a process and an unprocessed folder. And just hang on. I'm going to tell you what this process and unprocess is for. Just a little bit. And there's a couple of ways you can get your files in these folders. You can go to the unprocessed section because this will be new Parquet CSV Excel files that you got. So you can go here and you can choose upload files or folders, or you can use OneLake Explorer. If I go over to my OneLake Explorer, you can see the workspace. So each one of these folders represent a workspace. And in that workspace, I browse to the unprocessed folder. And then what I can do is I have some data here. I'm going to copy these three files and then I'm going to paste them over here into my OneLake Explorer. This is a manual process, but you don't want to write any code. So this will get synced up. And so let's head back over to Fabric in a web browser and we'll choose refresh. And there's the three files. So once the files are created, you want to create a table because you want to build a data set. You want to start creating Power BI reports and test out direct lake. So let's choose 2023, October 6th. And what we're going to do is click the ellipsis for that file and choose load to table. So we're going to click new table and we're just going to call this daily sales, except the default, unless you're using a different file type, and click load. So this will spin for a few seconds, but what's actually happening behind the scenes is it's taking that CSV file and it's making a managed table in my Lakehouse. So now it's taking that file and if I click it, it'll take a few seconds and it'll show the data. So this is a managed table. I can actually view it here. I can switch over to the SQL endpoint and I've written a query. You can see my query here and we'll click here and we'll run this query. Let's see how many rows. So we have 188 rows for 2006. And now you're thinking, Patrick, how do I get more data into this table? Let me show you, no code. So we'll head back out over to our Lakehouse and we're gonna go to unprocessed again and we'll choose 2007. And we're gonna do the exact same thing and we're gonna choose existing table. It's a different CSV file, but instead of saying overwrite, we're gonna choose a pin. We're gonna select that daily sales table and we're gonna click load. It'll take a few seconds for this particular file to get appended. And then what'll happen is if we go back over to our SQL endpoint, we're gonna switch over to that query. And I'm gonna run that query. So we should have two dates. We should have October 6th and October 7th. And now you may be thinking to yourself, well, Patrick, wait a minute. So I need to do this every time. Well, it's a simple approach, it's a quick approach, and it's actually a really elegant approach if you don't wanna write any code, create pipelines or data flows. But if you wanna automate this, let's say you figured out a way to drop these files into a folder that's, you know, connecting the fabric, and you just wanna have something that runs every day at 7 a.m. to automatically do this for you. How would you do it? Well, let me show you a simple pipeline pattern that'll make this work for you. Let's go back over to our Lakehouse. And what we're gonna do is I'm gonna go back to the OneLake Explorer, and I'm gonna take the two files that we already processed. I'm gonna cut them and then I'm gonna move them to the process folder. And then if we go back to unprocess, there's just one date. So we're gonna go over to Fabric in the Lakehouse. I'm gonna choose get data and we're gonna choose a pipeline. This is a really simple pattern that you can use. I'm gonna say load data to Lakehouse and you click create. So we click create. I'm gonna cancel this out. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to activities and I'm gonna choose copy activity. I'm not gonna use the copy assistance. I'm gonna say add this to the canvas. I'm gonna call this load unprocessed data to Lakehouse. That's what we're gonna do. Perfect. And then we're gonna click that activity. We're gonna choose source and we're gonna change the source to workspace, choose Lakehouse, and I'm gonna choose first Lakehouse. And then we're gonna click files, then we're gonna click browse, we're gonna choose unprocessed. And click OK. You need to be sure you specify your file format type. And so I'm going to choose the limited file because mine is the limited file. Pretty simple. Then we're going to choose destination. And for our destination, we're going to choose Lakehouse. We're going to choose first Lakehouse and we're going to say daily sales. So what this is going to do is actually going to look in that unprocessed folder to see if there's any files in that unprocessed folder and then append those to that daily sales table in my Lakehouse. And then we're going to add one more activity to this pipeline. We're going to add another copy data activity to the canvas. And what we're going to do is we're going to check this on success, connect these up, and we're going to change this one to move to process files. And then what we're going to do is we're going to click on that copy activity, choose source. We're going to switch that to workspace, choose our first Lakehouse, and then we're going to switch this to files, and we're going to choose browse, and we're going to say unprocess and click OK. After that, expand advanced and make sure you check this delete files on completion, because when we're done with this, we're going to take those unprocessed files, move them to the process folder, and then delete the file from the process file folder. So then you click destination. We're going to choose the first Lakehouse and choose files, and then we're going to click browse, and we're going to choose process. We click OK. We're going to click run here, and we're going to choose run. So save and run. It'll take a little bit, but what's going to happen is it's going to switch us over to the run activity. And if you click refresh, we can watch what's going on. So that's cute. So the first step has succeeded. It's loaded the data into the Lakehouse, the unprocessed files. And if we wait, this one is queued up. Boom, succeeded. Let's go validate this. So we're going to go back over to our Lakehouse. We're going to refresh this. So there's nothing unprocessed. And we go to process. Let's refresh this. See our three files. And then let's go over to the SQL endpoint to validate that now we have October 8 data in the Lakehouse just by running the quick query. And you'll see, boom, there we go. The 6th, 7th, and the 8th. All three files have been loaded into our Lakehouse. And the only code we wrote was a little T-SQL just to do some validation. But you could have used your default data set and used Power BI and created a table to validate this also. Either way will work. All right, what do you think? You ready to get started with the Lakehouse in Microsoft Fabric? You have questions, comments? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to know more about getting started with Fabric, check out the playlist that's flying over my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.